समांता रॉय, वाइस प्रेसिडेंट टेक्नोलॉजी स्ट्रेटजी एंड इनोवेशन कॉर्पोरेट इंजीनियरिंग टेक्नोलॉजी एंड ऑपरेशंस लॉकहीड मार्टिन. गुड आफ्टरनून सर.
गुड आफ्टरनून.
वांटेड टू नो अबाउट द सॉल्यूशंस ऑन द साइबर सिक्योरिटी फ्रंट दैट लॉकहीड इज प्रोवाइडिंग टू कस्टमर्स बिकॉज नॉट मेनी पीपल नो अबाउट द सॉल्यूशंस व्हिच आर कमिंग फ्रॉम लॉकहीड मार्टिन इन इंडिया.
So yes, so from a cybersecurity perspective, Lockheed Martin has been developing and providing services for some time. What I can say is that Lockheed Martin did have a business unit that was primarily devoted to providing cybersecurity, other types of information technology services. But in our broad strategic business plan, we decided to sell it off to another U.S. company. And so what we're doing on the cyber front is really providing essentially capabilities to customers primarily in the national security and arena. So I'm not going to say too much about those customers or the products that we provide, but I will say that we've also been engaging with a number of foreign governments, for instance, the government of India, as well as some other countries, where we help provide a framework for cybersecurity education based upon the experiences and the research that we've been doing, because the world of cybersecurity is a very fast, rapid, fluid environment. And our strength is we have the technical capabilities to stay at the leading edge, and we like to communicate to some of our customers domestically as well as internationally, the sort of an educational framework that they can teach their staff and their individual folks of how to address the cybersecurity.
Sir, would you talk about some of the solutions that you have provided to the U.S. government or other governments internationally?
So what I'm getting at is at the end, when we talk about our services and products that we provide, I mean, obviously in the world of cybersecurity, there's a lot of threats out there. So we provide capabilities that keep our customers safe and secure. And as I said, on the educational front, we've been providing a framework of how governments can actually train and educate their citizens and their employees on the importance of cybersecurity.
You have recently tied up with the Data Security Council of India for educating SMB segments or SMB enterprise on cybersecurity front.
Yes,
so would you elaborate on what other things that you are doing along with Data Security Council of India?
Absolutely. So this is really an exciting opportunity. Back in the fall of last year in 2015, our CEO, Ms. Marilyn Hewson, and the Prime Minister Modi of India basically had a conversation about the importance of cybersecurity, and that led to the launching of an initiative being executed through DSCI about a cybersecurity educational framework that really is addressing, if you will, small and medium enterprises and the pipeline of talent that goes in. So we've provided, if you will, and developed with the DSCI a set of videos, educational videos, computer-based training, as well as games and other things targeted at small and medium enterprises, as well as community colleges. So we've been very proud of this partnership of providing this framework that can help these develop these capabilities in the Indian workforce. The other thing I'll mention is, in addition to this activity, for now we're celebrating our 10th year anniversary of something called the India Innovation Growth Program. And this has been a wonderful partnership between Lockheed Martin. It's actually launched by our former Chief Technology Officer, Dr. Ray Johnson, who had the vision to create this great strategic partnership with India, and long-term focused on science and technology innovation. And we've been partnering with the Department of Science and Technology within the Indian government and a number of other entities within India. Namely, it was the Federation of Indian Chambers of Commerce and Industry, as well as the Indo-US Science and Technology Forum, to basically identify and nurture, great innovators within India, and try to help them, commercialize their entities and their innovations and ideas. We've now basically revitalized this program. We call it IIGP 2.0. And now we're working again very closely with the Department of Science and Technology. We brought in a new partner, Tata's, to help because they have great relationships and great capabilities within. We've brought in a new partner, the Tata's, which is a wonderful company. They have this strategic vision, and we're working with them to formulate IIGP 2.0. And we're going to continue to work with some other Indian entities. And it's going to be a very interesting program now that's also going to focus on not only identifying ideas, but to basically take them to that commercialization, as well as working with some of the preeminent Indian universities to help provide some challenge problems that we can bring in these ideas and grow the future S&T ecosystem within India. So I'm really excited about this activity.
Any advice to Indian government on cybersecurity front?
My advice, and I should probably provide this advice not so much as from a Lockheed Martin perspective, but just as a technologist looking at the world, is how I would caveat my comments is, cybersecurity is a very, very important threat. That the threats in cybersecurity are very important. We have to address. I think in the Indian government, with all the demonetization, all these other activities, really, and through Dr. Rai, the National Security Cyber Coordinator, really understands the problem. I think the big issue is the how you put the resources in and how to address these things. Lockheed Martin, as a global security provider, is interested in having some of our dialogues of some potential capabilities we can provide. But I think at the end of the day, my advice to is essentially, this is a really important, rapidly moving field. Technology development is going to be important, but also the regulatory and policy development is going to be important. And I think also steps that the Indian government have taken, like a strategic framework with the US government, have been very important and very forward-leaning. And I think that is going to just be in a very important field that the government will have to really focus on. Not only from like financial commercial sectors, but also from a critical infrastructure perspective too.
Thank you, Mr. Roy.
Thank you so much. Appreciate it. Thank you.